Hello, wonderful people. My name is Matthew, also known on the internet as TingThing. I'm the developer of Platform Builder, and welcome to this quick tutorial. This tutorial will give you a flyby overview of what Platform Builder is about and a quick tour of the different parts of this program so that you will know how to navigate your way around. I'm using Platform Builder version 3.2, and I'll be covering pages 1 through 3 of the in-game manual along with some other helpful information. So let's get started. You are looking at the main menu of Platform Builder right now. There are several different places that you can go. The Start section will take you to the place where you can construct, edit, and play your own full games from start to finish. The Explore section lets you play and check out other games that people have made and posted to the Platform Builder community. The Sandbox Mode lets you create levels that are without their own games, so something just a little more quick and casual for you if you prefer to do that. And then Options, of course, are different options. You can mess with the screen size, volume, keyboard controls are pretty important. Simply hover over a key that you want to change, press something like, I don't know why you'd want to do that, but R if you want to use up for R. I can change it back, of course, at any time, and there are player 1 controls, there's player 2 controls. There's also, if you have a gamepad installed, you can do that. So I have one right here, I'll click it into my USB, and you can see that you can also control the Platform Builder games with a Xbox controller in this case. So this is the options menu. There's, of course, credits, you know, if you're into that, I guess. Oh, look, there's me. Okay. Anyway, let's go back, and I want to show you basically a quick way to help you navigate through Platform Builder. In order to do this, we'll be opening up the example file. This, this comes with Platform Builder, so you click on that, hit edit. Now what you're looking at right now is the Overworld Editor of a pre-built game made by yours truly. The Overworld Editor is Overworlds, and as you can see, it is not a side-scroller platformer game, but rather it is a top-down type of game where you move up, down, left, right. These are the level icons that take you to different parts of the game, and you work your way through this to reach the goal. So this is the Overworld Editor. In order to move from different parts of Platform Builder, you will be going to the menu. So let's get out of the Overworld Editor. I'll click on the menu, and I want to show you the Course Editor. In order to get to the Course Editor, we need to edit a level that we have. So I'll click on Level Manager. From here, there's a bunch of pre-built levels that are already here with the example file. I'll just select one, hit edit, and this will show the Course Editor. This is the actual side-scrolling platformer style game that you'll be able to make and spend a lot of time with in Platform Builder. As you can see, there's all different sorts of things that you can build and construct and different fun things that you can do in your levels. That is the Course Editor. There is also the Game Screen Editor, and that would depend what type of game screen you're in. So for instance, there's the title screen. You can go here and create your own title screen for the games that you have. This is very similar in look to the Course Editor, except that you essentially are not designing something that you play on, but simply a scene, something that you would see when you visit the title screen of your game. You add some text to that, like the title, the author, and the different buttons, and it's a little different depending what screen you are working on, because there's also the game over screen and the victory screen. So we looked at the Overworld Editor, we looked at the Course Editor, this is the Game Screen Editor. The last part of Platform Builder is something called Game Setup, so let's go there now. Game Setup is a great part of Platform Builder that really lets you make your games unique in your own. From here you can change different aspects of Platform Builder itself. So for instance, you can change the character, you can modify how the character behaves, the different moves and attributes that the character has, you can change how the character looks, you can create your own custom enemies, your own custom items, projectiles, backgrounds. If you use Platform Builder Pro, you can upload your own backgrounds, music, tiles, and sprites, and sound effects. There's other settings as well, all different sorts of things that you can do with Game Setup, and I think you'll have a fun time just exploring that part of Platform Builder because there's so much that you can do. So what I want to do right now before we finish up is show you what it looks like to start a brand new game from scratch. I went back to the main menu and I'm going to click on Start. We're going to create a new game right here at the top. Click Yes, want to make that. You can name your game. I will call it My Awesome Game. Hit OK. Then you get the chance to choose between simple or advanced mode. I'm not going to explain this now, that'll be for a later video, but we'll just go to advanced mode, click on that. Now as you can see that this is a fresh start, a totally new game from scratch, and I'll be telling you how to construct stuff and add to your overworld and course editors and title screen and all that later. But for now I want to just show you how to navigate a little bit more. So click on menu. If we want to visit the course editor, you click on level manager again. And as you can see, this is empty because it's new. In order to get to a course, you need to have a level that's built. And so I'll click on new, create that, you can name it. I'm actually going to create a couple of these. And then what you do is you click on the one that you want to work with. You can delete it, you can rename it, or you hit edit. And that'll take you to the course editor. So from here, of course, you construct your courses, and that's how it is. So that's the level manager. The overworlds also have their own manager. You start with one world because that's just how the game begins, and you can add more worlds to that. You can also play with no worlds if you prefer to do that. That's something that you can set up in the game setup section of Platform Builder. But that's essentially what it is. That's how you find your way around Platform Builder. In future videos, I'll be showing you how to actually start building your games and doing all the fun nitty-gritty work in game design. So I look forward to seeing you then. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you later. Bye.